Hello learners, a very good day to all. This is Dr. Vishal Sood, teacher educator. In the previous lessons, we have studied about the difference between measurement, assessment and evaluation. As you know, that assessment is a process in which quantitative and qualitative data are collected regarding the student's characteristic. That characteristic may be like academic achievement of the student. So, and also we have learned that assessment can be carried out at any time during the teaching learning process. It depends on the nature of the content matter, it depends on the situation in the classroom, teaching learning process, that at what time the assessment is to be carried out by the teacher. It may be carried out after the completion of a single concept, it may be carried out at the end of a particular lesson, it may be carried out after two lessons. So, it depends on the situation, it depends on the nature of the content matter that at what time the assessment is to be carried out. And we have also studied in previous lessons that the assessment either is carried out for the improvement of the learning or it is carried out for grading the student or certifying the student to promote him to the next class. So, assessment is taken in two aspects. One is assessment of learning and the other is assessment for learning. Assessment for learning, that is known as formative assessment, and assessment of learning, which is carried out to grade the student or to certify the student as pass or fail and to promote him to the next class, is known as summative assessment. So, learners, today we will discuss on formative and summative assessment. Today's discussion will remain focused on these points. First, we will discuss about types of assessment. Then, we will discuss about formative assessment, which is assessment for learning. And we will discuss about the characteristics of formative assessment. Then, we will discuss about advantages of formative assessment for teachers. What advantages are there for the teachers if they carry out formative assessment during their teaching learning process? Then the discussion will be there on summative assessment, and in the last part of this presentation, we will study about the differences that exist between formative and summative assessment. So, let us start with types of assessment. As you know, the assessment can be differentiated or can be classified into different types depending on the nature. One assessment is formal, the other is informal. Formal assessment is just like to grade the student as pass or fail, or to grade the student or to certify the students as pass or fail and to promote them to the next class. That is a formal mechanism of assessment. Informal assessment, that is carried out by the teacher in the classroom to improve the learning among the students, to remove their learning difficulties and to enhance learning. So, that is a sort of informal learning, informal assessment for the student. Then another classification of assessment is objective assessment and subjective assessment. Objective assessment is that in which the objective type questions like multiple choice questions, fill in the blanks type or completion type questions, analogy type questions, matching type questions, they are involved. That sort of assessment is known as objective type assessment. And another is subjective type assessment, in which long answer type or essay type questions are included and in which the explanation abilities of the students are assessed. That type of evaluation or assessment is known as subjective assessment. You also know that these two terms, assessment and evaluation, they are synonymously used and they have certain difference, but they are synonymously used or interchangeably used. Another classification of assessment is formative evaluation or formative assessment and summative assessment. So, today's discussion will focus on this classification, that is formative assessment and summative assessment. Now, first of all, what is formative assessment? As you can imagine that the formative word, it has been taken from the word formation. Formation means the construction process of anything. Now, what construction process? What is constructed in the classroom? The knowledge is constructed in the classroom. And when during the construction of that knowledge or that understanding among the student, the assessment is carried out by the teacher, that sort of assessment is known as formative assessment, which is carried out during the formation of the content matter or during the formation of the knowledge in the classroom. That sort of assessment is called formative assessment. Formative assessment is a range of formal and informal assessment procedures which are employed by the teachers during the learning process in order to modify the teaching and learning activities and to improve student attainment. That means formative assessment is a range of formal and informal assessment procedures. That means it depends on the situation, it depends on the teacher, and it depends on the content matter, that whether the formal mechanism is to be employed to assess the students or the assessment is to be carried out by employing the informal assessment procedures. Formal assessment procedure may be the test, written test given to the student. Informal procedure may be observation of the student by the teacher in different activities, or the oral questioning from the students by the teacher. That is, these are the informal assessment procedure. So, formal and informal assessment procedures both are the part of formative assessment, and these formal and informal assessment procedures are employed by the teachers during the teaching learning process to improve or bring modifications in the teaching learning activities and to improve student learning or enhance learning among the students. Then, formative assessment, it is an ongoing process usually carried out by the teacher to continuously monitor students' progress in a non-threatening and supportive environment. That means it is a continuous process. It is carried out by the teacher to continuously monitor what the students' progress, what the students have learned, what they have not learned. The environment of the class is non-threatening, supportive, very conducive, so that student can learn at ease, they can learn more and more, and learning could be enhanced among them. So, it is a regular process to monitor students' progress and remove their learning difficulties. Then, the formative assessment characteristics. Now, what are the major characteristics of formative assessment? First, this assessment is built upon students' prior knowledge and experience in designing what is taught. That means students' previous knowledge, the prior knowledge, what they learn about or what they have already with them about their topic under consideration is taken in consideration by the teacher. That means formative assessment is based on students' previous knowledge. Then it is conducted at regular intervals, on informal basis or formal basis. That means it is a regular process. It can be conducted at the end of a particular concept. It can be conducted after 15 minutes or 10 minutes depending on the nature of the content matter, or it can be conducted at the end of a particular class. It can be conducted at the end of two classes, at the end of a particular topic. So, it is conducted at regular intervals so as to know what are the learning difficulties or to identify the learning gaps, where the learning gaps are remaining. Then those learning gaps are identified by the teacher on the basis of this formative assessment, and the feedback is, or the remedial measures are provided to the students to improve learning among them. This formative assessment is diagnostic in nature. Diagnostic means to identify the learning difficulties of the students. What are the hard spots? Then there is a provision of remedial instruction or the feedback or the corrective measures for the students so that they can learn in an appropriate manner and to the optimum level. And it ensures provision for effective feedback. That means feedback is provided to the students on the basis of formative assessment so that their mistakes, their errors, or their difficulties could be sorted out. Then this assessment provides a platform for the active involvement of students in their own learning. That means in such type of formative assessment, the students are involved in knowing their mistakes, what difficulties they are facing, and how those learning difficulties can be removed. There is two-way traffic in such type of assessment where both teacher and the students are actively involved to enhance learning. Then It encourages intrinsic motivation among the students. Students are intrinsically, internally motivated to enhance learning or to improve their knowledge and understanding about the content matter. The purpose of this assessment is to improve quality of student learning, and it should not be evaluative or involve grading of students. This thing must be kept in consideration while making formative assessment. That means purpose of this assessment is to improve the quality of student learning, to enhance learning among students. It should not be evaluative or involve grading. That means on the basis of formative assessment, we do not grade the students. We do not certify the students as pass or fail. Rather, we say the students have learned these concepts and have not learned or understood these concepts. And on the basis of that, we provide remedial measures or feedback to the students so that the unlearned concepts could be learned by or could be understood by the students. This type of assessment, formative assessment, encourages students to understand the criteria that will be used to judge their work. Means the students are made understood about that what type of learning, at what sort of learning is expected from them, what the teacher will expect from them. That criteria are made clear to the students so that they can continue their learning in an appropriate manner. Formative assessment offers an opportunity to students to improve their work after they get the feedback. That means there is provision of feedback to the students on their learning difficulties, and opportunities are provided to the students to improve their learning, to improve their work. So these are the characteristics of formative assessment. Now, what are the advantages of formative assessment for teachers? Just like you are teachers sitting at different places, what are the advantages of formative assessment to you? On the basis of formative assessment, you can identify and nurture students' potentialities. That means on the basis of the results of the formative assessment, you can identify what are the capabilities of your students, what special capabilities they are having, and how to nurture them, how those capabilities can be taken to the optimum level, to the highest level. Then you can know through formative assessment, and you can nurture, you can nourish those students' potentialities in a better way. Then formative assessment is helpful for you as a teacher. You can improve your teaching on the basis of formative assessment results. You can know where the students have learned and where the students have not learned. Why the students have not learned? Whether the teaching method employed by you was not appropriate? If not, then you can modify your teaching. You can bring change in your teaching strategies. So it will help in modifying your future teaching. Then it provides you feedback. It provides the feedback to the students regarding their learning performance, as well as it provides feedback to the teachers to improve their teaching activities. So it is also an advantage for the teacher. Then formative assessment is also advantageous in terms of identifying learning difficulties and providing remedial measures. That means on the basis of formative assessment, a teacher can identify the learning difficulties, the hard spots or the mistakes or the causes responsible for those learning errors, and how to remove those errors, how to remove those difficulties, what type of remedial measures can be provided to the students. All this can be possible through formative assessment. So formative assessment is very much advantageous for the students as well as for the teachers. Now, another assessment is summative assessment. What we mean by summative assessment? Summative assessment, as the word itself says, summative means sum total. Such type of assessment which is carried out at the end of a particular unit, at the end of a particular session, at the end of the particular semester, or at the end of provision of learning experiences, at the completion of the provision of learning experiences, such type of assessment is known as summative assessment. Summative assessment refers to the assessment of the learning that sums or summarizes the development of students at a particular time. This is a process of assessing and grading or ranking the learning of the students at a point of time. That means either at the end of the semester or at the end of the particular year. Just like, you know, you take tests of the students after 6 months or at the end of the session, that is annual examination. So that annual examination or half yearly examinations, they all come under the purview of summative assessment, which is done at the end of particular semester or particular year. And why we carry out such type of assessment? We carry out such assessment to grade the student, to rank the students, to promote the student to the next class. So this is summative assessment. Whereas on the other hand, we carry out formative assessment not for grading the student or certifying the student or ranking the student. Formative assessment is for improving the learning, for identifying the difficulties, for providing remedial measures, whereas summative assessment is for this grading or certifying the students. The tests used in such type of summative assessment are called summative tests. The tests which are used at the time of annual examination or half yearly examination, they are known as summative tests. Assessment of learning performance, which is conducted at the end of a course or a unit of a course, is summative assessment. It is taken by the student at the end of a course generally or academic year to demonstrate the sum of what they have learned. That means what the students have learned during a particular year or during a particular course, that is demonstrated through summative assessment. The results of the summative assessment are used for ranking or grading the students, which we have already discussed, that summative assessment is for ranking or grading the students or promoting the students to the next class. Now, you can see on the screen what are the differences between formative assessment and summative assessment. Formative assessment, it is used to determine how much the students have learned and what they still have to learn. That means it is for improvement of learning. On the other hand, you can see on the screen, summative assessment is used to determine a student's overall performance in a certain prescribed course. That means in formative assessment, what the students have learned, what they have not learned, it is identified. Whereas in summative assessment, it is used to determine the student's overall performance in a prescribed course. The second difference in formative and summative assessment is the grades in formative assessment, they do not carry much weight. There is no provision of grading or ranking in formative assessment. Whereas, on the other hand, grades are the basis for determining the readiness of the student to take statewide test and in evaluating the overall academic performance. That means the summative assessment emphasizes on grading or ranking of the students, and these grades determine the readiness of the students to take the board tests or the board examination and evaluating their overall academic performance. The third difference between formative assessment and summative assessment, that in formative assessment, the tests are frequently administered. This type of assessment is regular on continual basis during the teaching learning process so that the learning difficulties could be identified. So it is much frequent in nature. Whereas in summative assessment, the tests are conducted at the terminal stage of a course. That means the tests or the testing is done at the end of a particular year or at the end of a particular course. Whereas formative assessment, it is during the teaching learning process, during the construction of the knowledge, during the formation of the knowledge. So this is the third difference between formative and summative assessment. Then the other difference between formative and summative assessment is that formative assessment, it is less formal and more informal. That means the classroom environment is non-threatening, very conducive, where both teacher and students work together to reach to the optimum level of learning among the students. So formative assessment is less formal or more informal, which is conducted at the school level by the classroom teacher. That means formative assessment is conducted by the teacher. Summative assessment, on the other hand, is more formal. There are more formalized procedures, more formal mechanism is involved in summative assessment, which is conducted at the school level, but with the instruction from the higher authorities, the district authorities or the state authorities. That means the teacher cannot conduct such type of summative assessment at his or her own will. It is the instruction from the higher authorities to conduct or to carry out such type of summative assessment at the end of a course or at the end of a particular session. Whereas formative assessment, it can be carried out by the teacher at any stage of learning, so that the learning among the students could be enhanced, their learning difficulties could be identified and removed. Then another difference between formative assessment and summative assessment is that formative assessment is flexible as per the needs of the students. There are more flexibilities in carrying out formative assessment by the teacher, whereas summative assessment is rigid in nature. It is inflexible in nature. There is one test for all students. There is uniform way of conducting and uniform standard of interpreting the test scores. And this uniformity in the tests, in the interpretation of the test scores, is decided by the higher authorities, just like boards of school education or the district authorities or the state authorities, which determine what criteria will be used to grade the students as pass or fail, or what criteria will be used to promote the students to the next higher class. Just like 35% is a criterion which is used generally to grade the students as pass or fail. Those students getting marks less than 35% are graded as fail, whereas those students who achieve marks more than 35% or 35%, they are certified as pass. So this criterion is fixed by the authorities, and this is a uniform standard for all students. Whereas in case of formative assessment, such type of rigid criterion is not there. It is flexible, and it depends on the abilities of the student, what criteria, what parameters are to be fixed to for a particular student. Then the last difference between the formative assessment and summative assessment is that formative assessment is process oriented. That means in this formative assessment, we try to improve the teaching learning process. We try to improve the learning among the students. We try to identify the learning difficulties of the students. We try to provide them remedial measures. We try to provide them feedback so that learning or their achievement could be enhanced. Whereas summative assessment is not process oriented. It only sees the outcome or the result, final result, that is at the end of the session or at the end of a course. So it is summative assessment is outcome oriented in nature. So these were the differences between formative and summative assessment. Now, two terms are used. One is assessment of learning and other is assessment for learning. Assessment of learning. This means we are assessing the learning, what the students have gained and what the students have not gained. And this term assessment of learning is summative in nature, which is intended to measure learning outcomes. What are the final results as an outcome, or at the end of a particular course, or at the end of a particular session? That is assessment of learning, which is summative in nature. Whereas assessment for learning means to improve learning. Assessment is done for improving learning among the students, which is formative in nature, which is intended to improve learning, which is intended to monitor students' progress. What are the particular learning difficulties faced by the students? What are the causes of those particular learning difficulties? How those causes can be removed? How that learning can be improved? So assessment for learning is formative in nature, whereas assessment of learning is summative in nature. So this is the difference between formative and summative assessment. So learners, what we discussed today, what we learned today, we discussed about type of assessment, formal and informal assessment. Then we also discussed about objective assessment and subjective assessment. Then we discussed about formative and summative assessment. We discussed in detail formative assessment, its characteristics. Then we discussed what are the advantages of formative assessment for teachers. The teachers can improve their teaching strategies. What instructional materials can be more effective in teaching that can be ascertained through formative assessment. What are the advantages of formative assessment for students? How their learning difficulties can be removed with the help of formative assessment? How the feedback can be or remedial measures can be provided to the students with the help of formative assessment, about which we have discussed in detail. Then we discussed about summative assessment. What we mean by summative assessment, which is carried out at the end of a particular session, at the end of a particular course, and which is done to certify or to grade the students as pass or fail, that is summative assessment, which is outcome oriented in nature. And in the last, we discussed about the differences between formative and summative assessment. The one is process oriented, formative assessment is process oriented in nature, and on the other hand, summative assessment is outcome oriented in nature. So we discussed, we understood about these differences between formative and summative assessment. I hope that you all have learned and understood about the characteristics, the advantages, and the differences between the formative and summative assessment. Thank you. Have a nice day.